One of the drawbacks to X10 that I had mentioned is that there is sometimes signal noise on the electrical line. As an experienced user of X10, I can attest to this happening. It can sometimes seem as though there is an X10 poltergeist in your house. A setup that has worked normally for months or years suddenly stops working, and after attempting to troubleshoot, you figure out that the problem is someone plugged a tablet in to charge in an outlet, and that suddenly makes everything haywire. This is frankly a strong argument for some of the other X10 alternatives, but there are steps you can take to mitigate and nearly eliminate the problem with your own X10 setup itself, and I have pretty good luck with mine on the whole. One of the first things that you can do is to be strategic about what you plug in and where. Computers and other electronics tend to give the X10 system fits, so avoid plugging things like this into your network, say, right next to your controller's access or to a transceiver. But here is some hardware that you can call in to help as well. The lowest cost and lowest impact solution is the plug-in noise filter shown here. I've used this personally after identifying particularly troublesome components, and it does work. My girlfriend had a laptop once that just gave the home automation network absolute fits, but once we slapped this onto the end of her laptop's power adapter, it never bothered the network again. You can see some likely culprits listed here, and if you can identify them via testing, these filters can be a great solution. I've had some success plugging multiple culprits into a power strip and filtering all of the noise in one fell swoop. It's not a guarantee, but it's a help. If filtering out the noise isn't effective, you can always go the other route and boost your signal. The booster link allows you to do this, albeit for a pretty penny. This is an Insteon product, which explains the higher price tag, but it also gives you a good feeling of reliability, as I understand it. Full disclosure is that I have never actually tried this product myself. It's simple to install in that you just plug it in, preferably near your transceiver or your controller, since the booster has to be able to pick up the original signal in order to amplify it. Of course, if you want to invest the money, you can have multiple boosters strategically around the house as well. Another thing worth mentioning here is that this tends to be a great solution for apartments and condominiums, where the electrical circuits could conceivably be shared between units, and the phases certainly are. In other words, if you live in an apartment, it's possible that your appliances and electronics aren't the only source of signal degradation and noise. Since you can't very well ask your neighbor to plug his home entertainment center into one of your filters, boosting the strength of your signal is a great alternative. This will have no adverse effect on your neighbor's home electrical either, for what it's worth. The last product that I'll mention is a phase coupler, which comes in two varieties. The first is an attachment that goes on your home's breaker box, and it helps to boost weak signals. The idea behind this is that most home electric comes from the grid at 240 volts, but is split into two 120 volt phases for your house. If you have a controller on one phase and a receiver module on the other phase, the signal actually goes all the way to your breaker box and then out of the house to wherever this split occurs outside, and then all the way back in, presenting plenty of opportunities for signal degradation. The phase coupler short-circuits this by allowing the X10 messages to make the jump right at your breaker box. Incidentally, if you live in an apartment and do not have full access to your breaker box for some reason, this approach is a non-starter. I would not recommend doing this wiring yourself, as you have to cut the full house power and you're messing with the electricity coming in from outside to your circuit breaker, meaning that you don't have the safeguard of a breaker turning over if something goes haywire. If you feel comfortable with this, then you can do it, but I actually paid an electrician to do this at my house. The other option I'm showing is available to you if you have an unused 240 volt outlet, the way you see sometimes for dryers. The 240 volt line coming into the house actually has both phases feeding into it, so this is the perfect place to do such a join. The unit does the deed by simply being plugged in. Unfortunately, this unit is discontinued and not readily available, so if you want one, you're going to have to monitor eBay and find it to give it a try.